3 formula we have in case of write down when there is a phase change. This is important. JEE the question aa chuka hai. In case of phase change. Write down first delta S of fusion. Fusion means what? Delta S of fusion is equals to the enthalpy change for this process, delta H of fusion, divided by the temperature at which the melting is taking place, which is the melting point, right? So fusion is melting. Basically, we write down here the energy change divided by the temperature at which the phase is taking place, right? So delta S of vaporization, what we'll write? Delta H of vaporization divided by the temperature. This temperature is what? Should be the boiling point. This is what? Melting point. Delta S of sublimation. What?
Delta S.
Yeah, so that is equilibrium. Both pe aayenge abhi. And equilibrium mein delta G is zero. तो वहां से आ रहा है डेल्टा जी. अभी गिब्स एनर्जी वी हैवंट डन. सो व्हेन यू डू दैट आई विल टेल यू एट इक्विलिब्रियम डेल्टा जी विल बी जीरो एंड दैट्स व्हाई वी गेट दिस फॉर्मूला राइट. सो इक्विलिब्रियम पे गिब्स फ्री एनर्जी इज ऑलवेज जीरो डेल्टा जी. ओके सब्लिमेशन दिस बाय टी on this temperature at which this solid to it. Write down this question. Write down the heat capacity. The heat capacity of liquid water is the heat capacity of liquid water is 75.6 joule per mole Kelvin. 75.6 joule per mole Kelvin. While the enthalpy of fusion of ice is while the enthalpy of fusion of ice is 6 kilojoule per mole. What is the smallest number of ice cubes? What is the smallest number of ice cubes at 0 degrees Celsius? What happened? Each containing 9 gram of water needed to cool 500 gram of liquid water at 20 degrees Celsius to 0 degrees Celsius. Ice cubes at 0 degrees Celsius, each containing 9 gram of water needed to cool 500 gram of liquid water from 20 degrees Celsius to 0 degrees Celsius. क्या
क्वेश्चन
सर
this one.
So yes sir, it's a cyclic process.
This we have done? This question?
Faster volume, sir.
You need to find out work done in this process. I don't think we have
done. Negative 48.
Minus 48. What is the work done in this?
14.
You see, work done in this process will be work done from A to B plus work done in B to C. This is the work done we
have.
So BC and AD is better. You see, this BC and AD is isocoding, right? B to C and D to A is isocoding. So work done will be zero. Right, volume is constant. What? What code? Previous one. I will see that bit. Finish. Right. Now A to B. What is the process? It is isobaric. It is also isobaric, right? Constant pressure is 10 and 2 respectively. So here pressure is minus 10 external pressure into change in volume is what? 9 minus 3 plus here it will be minus 2 into 3 minus 9. Minus 60 plus 12, that will be minus 48. Unit is what? Unit is ATM liter. And when you multiply this by, it will be joule. Right? This is one way to solve this question. Another way is what? If PV axis, PV graph, area under the curve is nothing but the work done. Right? So what is the area of this rectangle? Length into breadth, right? So this is 8 and this is 6. That is 48. Directly if you find out area, you will get it, the work done, the magnitude of the work done. Now you see the process is cyclic, it is anti-clockwise, sorry, clockwise. It is clockwise. So clockwise is always work done by the system, right? So clockwise is work done by the system, magnitude is this, since it is by the system, so we have to introduce one negative sign here, 48 ATM liter again the unit is.
So suppose we do the same question, anti-clockwise.
Plus 40. Plus 40.
This method will be plus 40.
Yes, yes, yes. Obviously clear. This will be positive, this will be negative.
So BF and BI will keep changing.
Sir, but how do you know that work done by the system is clockwise?
See, actually this is the theory. How do we get? You're getting negative. That's why I solve this. Negative, negative sign. Negative sign by the system. So what we can, the theory is what? If it is clockwise, then by the system. That's how we get. First question, what is the answer?
14.
Okay, how do we solve this question? Options are 1, 7, 14 and none of these. Okay. How many of you have solved this? The first one? 1, 2, 3. Chalo, Viraj.
So you want to understand analytics, sir.
He'll write properly.
Oh, I won't write it.
My
identity is
so much confidence here.
So
I need the value.
You need to explain really? What value you need?
Oh, like, I can't remember.
I'll give you the question.
The specifically
the question number 80.
Not specifically, heat capacity.
Question number 80.
75 points.
So one of them. Thank you. So I will leave the unit and all that.
I'll take attendance by then.
Ishan is present.
Who is present?
Ishan.
Bro, it's any sort of reading. It's not your fusion. I don't know what your flight is.
Are you actually going with Koini Sunday? It's
a fusion. Jenny, let me
write.
I will write.
Oh.
Oh.
Jenny
with
experience.
Don't put this on the board. Isko mat rakho isko.
Ha. Okay, then.
I think he's present, no? Akshir is present. Anand is present. Anush is present. Anand is present. Anush, Chaitanya, Dhruv, Harris, Hia, Ishan. Ishan, who is Ishan?
Half more. So total.
How bad does it look?
Oh, it looks like a toddler.
Did you understand this? Kya likha? I did not know. I don't know what it's basically it is MS delta T. Q is equals to this formula, you know, MS or NS delta T. N is number of moles, 500 by 80. S value is given. Delta T is 20. You'll get this. 42 kilojoule of energy. Okay, one more question you write down first. This was in KVPY's question. Write down 10 moles of an ideal gas. 10 moles of an ideal gas. 10 moles of an ideal gas. Confined to a volume of 10 liter. Confined to a volume of 10 liter is released into atmosphere at 300 Kelvin. Where the pressure is 1 bar. Find out the work done by the gas.
Wait, so what was the temperature?
300 Kelvin. 10 moles, 10 liter, 300 Kelvin, 1 bar pressure.
External pressure.
1 bar.
External pressure is
1 bar. It's not. The line is released into atmosphere where the pressure is 1 bar.
External.
What is the next chapter we have to start? No.
This is our sample.
This is thermodynamics. No, no, next class of
So we have to do all those different types of enthalpies.
Ah, that thermochemistry, next class.
So minus 240 liter ATM.
Minus 49, 59, 39, 20. It's 249 to 39. See, V1 is given. V2 you find out from P equals to RT. And then P delta V. V1 is 10 liter. V2 we need to find out. And for that, number of moles, pressure, temperature, everything is
given. 240, is it?
So it's 240. So work done is minus P delta V. What is the pressure given?
So
minus 1 delta V is
So this is also we are not getting.
But when you take this value, so one more digit we consider.
How is the pressure?
Then you'll get 240. Now you are getting 0.083 according to the option, you are getting 239, which is given in the 240 you are getting, right? 240 is all close to 239. Options are 239, 249, 229, 220. 239. Okay, so one last thing write down.
Sir, how is pressure 1, sir?
1 bar it is given.
Yeah, so the formula is P external data.
External pressure. One write down, one last thing. Statement of second law of thermodynamics. Clausius statement. Write down. It is impossible to construct a machine. Clausius statement. It is impossible to construct a machine with 100% efficiency. It is impossible to construct a machine with 100% efficiency. Or next thing to write down, or write down in between, and then next thing to write down. It is impossible to convert heat into work without any compensation. It is impossible to convert heat into work without any compensation. Complete conversion basically it's not possible. Another one you write down in terms of entropy, this is important. It also states that
sir, but that's what we said. No, so an isothermic delta U is 0 and H is 0. So that's then isn't that contradictory to this?
What? Delta U is 0.
Yeah. So, so we said W is equal to minus Q.
Yeah.
So but here it says converting heat into work is not possible.
That is conservation of energy.
No, so the second law puts limitations of the first law.
That's what? That is conservation of energy. And then we have second law which says that complete conversion of heat into work is not possible. Right. Yeah, so we have some drawbacks in first law. We have some drawbacks in third, second law.
So the second law basically tells us the first law is wrong.
Yeah, second law is, that's what he said. Put some constraint on the first law. Right on next line to this. It also states that the entropy of the universe increases in a spontaneous process. It also states that the entropy of the universe increases in a spontaneous process and remains unchanged at equilibrium. Right? So delta S of the universe or delta S total, universe means delta S total, is equals to delta S of the system plus delta S of surroundings.
So what is surrounding the universe?
Surrounding, see, system plus surrounding gives you universe. And delta S universe total entropy. Okay? This will be greater than zero for a spontaneous process. And delta, see, universe and total, same thing. Don't get confused with that. Okay? Delta S of universe at equilibrium will be zero. So this condition is at equilibrium. Right. So next class we'll see the significance of Gibbs free energy. We'll finish this chapter thermodynamics, and then we'll start thermochemistry. Thermochemistry involves only definitions, enthalpy of formation, combustion, and all. Okay. But that is important.
Hess's energy known in this chapter.
Yeah, we'll do that in thermochemistry. Okay. Okay. Thank you.